Hello everyone, in this lecture I will discuss about 5-hydroxytryptamine agonists and antagonists. It is also called serotonin. What is serotonin? It is also known as 5-hydroxytryptamine and widely distributed amine, a neurotransmitter, and also as an autocoid. That means it produced locally and has local effects. It is synthesized from tryptophan by hydroxylation followed by decarboxylation. It also involves many conditions such as migraine, gastrointestinal disturbances and sleeping disorders, memory and psychosis. It regulates mood and social behavior, means well-being. And in humans, 90% of 5-hydroxytryptamine in the body content is localized in the intestine, and most of the rest are in the platelets and brain, that is 10%. And it is stored as catecholamines. It is also found in plants and insects. Plants like tomato, banana, pineapple, peas, and freshy part of cashew nut. And lower animals or insects like arthropods, wasps, scorpions, sting and snake, and bee venom. And coming to the physiological distribution of serotonin, 10% is in CNS or neurons, and 90% 5-hydroxytryptamine is in enterochromaffin cells in GI tract. Yes, coming into the synthesis, metabolism and destruction. It is synthesized from dietary tryptophan to 5-hydroxytryptamine by the enzyme tryptophan hydroxylase, and this 5-hydroxytryptamine is again converted into 5-hydroxytryptamine by the enzyme tryptamine decarboxylase, and is also degraded by monoamino oxidase into 5-hydroxyindoleacetic acid, and it is excreted in urine. And next, biosynthesis of serotonin or 5-hydroxytryptamine. It is formed from dietary tryptophan. First, it is converted by tryptophan hydroxylase into 5-hydroxytryptophan, and then by tryptophan decarboxylase it is into 5-hydroxytryptamine. This 5-hydroxytryptamine is 90% of it is stored in the enterochromaffin cells of the intestine and in the meiotic flexes, and 10% is distributed in brain, platelets, lungs, bone marrow, and pineal gland. Here, this 5-hydroxytryptamine is degraded by monoamino oxidase it into 5-hydroxyindoleacetaldehyde, which is oxidized to 5-hydroxyindoleacetic acid. It is excreted in urine, and it is an indicator of 5-hydroxytryptamine product in the body. For example, in carcinoid disease, urinary excretion of 5-hydroxytryptamine indoleacetic acid is more. Next, coming into the receptors, we will talk about receptors. Serotonin have or 5-hydroxytryptamine have 7 major types of receptors, that is 5-hydroxytryptamine 1, 5-hydroxytryptamine 2, 5-hydroxytryptamine 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. These are the major type of receptors, 7 major types of receptors, and 5-hydroxytryptamine has been divided into subtypes, that is 5-hydroxytryptamine 1A, 5-hydroxytryptamine 1B, 5-hydroxytryptamine 1C, 5-hydroxytryptamine 1D, and 5-HT1E and 5-HT1F. And next, 5-HT2 receptors has been divided into 5-HT2A, 2B and 2C. And 5-HT3 receptor is located in the CNS. And 5-HT4 receptor is present in the GIT causing peristalsis. 5-HT5 receptor is present located in the CNS, like 5-HT6 and 7 receptors are also located in the CNS. And 5-HT receptors are mainly two types, D type or musculotropic, and M type is also called neurotropic receptors. These receptors blocked by dibenzoline or phenoxybenzamine and morphine. And methylsergide and cyproheptadine are the classical blockers of 5-hydroxytryptamine receptors. And it has 4 families, means 7 5-hydroxytryptamine receptor types. Here 7 types of 5-hydroxytryptamine receptors. In this, 5-hydroxytryptamine H1, tryptamine 1 and 2, 3 receptors and 4 to 7 receptors has shown similar properties or similar actions. These all receptors are having G protein coupled receptors except 5-hydroxytryptamine 3. Hydroxytryptamine 1 inhibits cyclic AMP and 5-hydroxytryptamine 4, 6, 7 it increases cyclic AMP levels. Now coming into the 5-hydroxytryptamine 1 receptors, it has 5 subtypes, that is HT1A, B, D, E and F. These all act as autoreceptors and G protein coupled receptors, that is GIN, G, GO subtypes. It inhibits or decreases cyclic AMP levels and calcium channel. Hydroxytryptamine 1A is located in the brainstem and hippocampus. It shows neuronal inhibition behavior effects, that is sleep, feeding, thermoregulation and anxiety. It is a partial agonizer buspirone and antagonist is ergotamine. Five hydroxytryptamine 1B is located in the CNS. Is a this main function is presynaptic inhibition and behavior function behavior effects and pulmonary vasoconstriction. These agonists are triptans. And next, 5-hydroxytryptamine 1D. It is located in the CNS, cranial blood vessels. This main function is cerebral vasoconstriction. And agonists is triptans such as sumatriptan, and antagonist is ergotamine. Next, 5-hydroxytryptamine 2 receptors. It has divided into three subtypes, 5-hydroxytryptamine 2A, 2B and 2C. These all are GQ type of proteins and increased IP3 levels and calcium levels and DAG levels. It is widely distributed in post-junctional D-type, located in the all smooth muscles, vascular and visceral, and also present in platelets and cerebral neurons. It mediates direct action like vasoconstriction and intestinal and uterine and bronchial constriction. Bronchial constriction and platelet aggregation and activation of cerebral neurons, etc. And specific antagonist is ketanserin, ritanserin, ciproheptadine and methysergide. And agonists are lysergic acid diethylamine and alpha methyl 5-hydroxytryptamine. This is about 5-hydroxytryptamine 2A. And 5-hydroxytryptamine 2B is located in the gastric fundus. This main function is it causes contraction, and agonists are LSD and alpha methyl 5-HT. And next receptor, 5-hydroxytryptamine 2C. It is located in the CNS, hypothalamus, and it causes vasodilatation and neuronal excitation. Here agonists are LSD and alpha methyl 5-hydroxytryptamine, antagonists are methylsergide. Next receptor are 5-hydroxytryptamine receptor. It is located in the CNS and PNS, is present in the chemoreceptor trigger zone, and NTS means nucleus tractus solitarius, and causes nausea and vomiting. PNS nerve endings causes pain, itch, or coronary chemoreflex and fall in BP or bradycardia. Specific antagonist is ondansetron, dalansetron, granisetron and polansetron and tropisetron. And 5-hydroxytryptamine 4 is located in the GI tract and CNS. It causes neuronal excitation and GI motility. It activates or increases cyclic AMP levels, and agonist is metoclopramide and sisapride. And next receptor is 5-hydroxytryptamine 5, 6, 7. These are the similar properties. It is located in the CNS and gastrointestinal tract. And signaling system is same as above, means 5-hydroxytryptamine 4. Hydroxytryptamine 4 like GS type of receptors, and 5-hydroxytryptamine 7 is present in the or located in the CNS, GI tract and blood vessels. And specific agonists are sisapride and renzapride, and 5-hydroxytryptamine 5, 6, 7 are closely related to 5-hydroxytryptamine 4. Next, coming to the pharmacological actions of 5-hydroxytryptamine on CVS. It has anotropic and chronotropic effects. Blood vessels are constricted. Due to direct action, vasodilator in the skeletal muscles and heart. On heart, it causes bradycardia due to stimulation of coronary chemoreflex. It causes bradycardia, hypotension and apnea. On blood pressure, it shows triphasic response or triple response on BP. First, early shock falls, it means false BP due to decreased cardiac output and bradycardia, and second, rising BP due to increased peripheral vasoconstriction and increased cardiac output, and finally falling BP due to vasodilatation in the skeletal muscles. If 5-hydroxytryptamine is given by rapid intravenous injection. Next, 5-hydroxytryptamine action on smooth muscles. On GIT, direct and through enterochromaffin cells in the mucosa and main, 5-hydroxytryptamine in the body increases GI motility, causes increased peristalsis and diarrhea. On bronchi, it constricts bronchi but less potent than histamine. Glands, 5-hydroxytryptamine inhibits gastric acid and pepsin secretion, however increases mucus production, thus it has ulcer protective properties. And nerve endings, 5-hydroxytryptamine activates afferent nerve endings, causes stinging and pricking sensation and also cause pain. On respiration, hyperventilation may occur due to stimulation of bronchial sensory nerve endings by 5-hydroxytryptamine. On platelets, 5-hydroxytryptamine, there is a changes in shape and size of platelets. And CNS, it is a poor entry to blood-brain barrier. And a neurotransmitter, it regulates appetite, sleep and mood behavioral changes. नेक्स्ट आई विल डिस्कस अबाउट 5-हाइड्रोक्सीट्रिप्टामिन एगोनिस. हाइड्रोक्सीट्रिप्टामिन एगोनिस दीज आर ड्रग्स और सेरेटोनिन एंटागोनिस और 5-हाइड्रोक्सीट्रिप्टामिन एंटागोनिस सर सुमाट्रिप्टिन फ्लुओक्सेटिन बुस्पेरान सिसाप्राइड and LSD undergo alkaloids, lysergic acid, diethylamide and ergotalkaloids. These are the serotonin agonists or 5-hydroxytryptamine agonists. Now first we will discuss about tryptans. Those are sumatriptan, zolmitriptan, naratriptan and rizatriptan. These are the tryptans. And first we will discuss about sumatriptan. Sumatriptan bioavailability is 97% by subcutaneous administration and 14% by oral administration and 17% by nasal spray. And the elimination of half-life is approximately 1 to 2 hours. And it is metabolized by monoamino oxidase A and is excreted in urine. Zolmitriptan bioavailability is 40% by oral route. First it is converted to N-desmethyl metabolite. It is having higher affinity for 5-HT1B and 5-HT1D receptors than does the patent drug. Both the metabolite and parent drug have half-lives of 2 to 3 hours. And next tryptan is naratriptan. It is administered by oral route. Bioavailability is 70%. It has longest acting drug. Plasma half-life is 6 hours. Rizatriptan oral bioavailability is 45%. The principal route of metabolism of rizatriptan is via oxidative deamination by monoamino oxidase. That means metabolism occurs through oxidative deamination by monoamino oxidase A. Adverse drug reactions of 5-hydroxytryptamine, it causes minor side effects. That is transient mild pain, stinging or burning sensation at the site of injection, coronary artery vasospasm, transient myocardial ischemia, arterial and ventricular arrhythmias, myocardial infarction, and nasal spray causes bitter taste. And it also causes fatigue and flushing, feeling of pressure, tightness or pain in the chest, neck and jaw. And also causes drowsiness and dizziness. Contraindications. It is not given to ischemic patients or coronary arterial disease patients and cerebrovascular or peripheral vascular diseases and other cardiovascular diseases. And in patients with uncontrolled hypertension, and naratriptan is contraindicated in patients with severe renal or hepatic impairment, and sumatriptan and rizatriptan and zolmitriptan are contraindicated in patients who are taking monoamine oxidase inhibitors such as salicylate, tyramine and phenazine. Uses of 5-hydroxytryptamine. It is used in postpartum hemorrhoids and migraine. Now coming into the 5-hydroxytryptamine antagonist. Hydroxytryptamine or serotonin antagonists are ergot derivatives like ergotamine, ergonovine and methylazide, and it is also partial agonist and antagonist, and alpha blockers, phenoxybenzamine, antihistaminics, cyproheptadine and cinnarizine, phenothiazines like chlorpromazine and ketanserin is the 5-hydroxytryptamine antagonist, which is used in antihypertension, and clozapine is also used for schizophrenia, and metoclopramide, ondansetron and granisetron, these are the currently available as anti-emetic drugs to treat chemotherapeutic induced nausea and vomiting. First, we will discuss about ergot alkaloids, that is ergometrine. It is a amine ergot alkaloid and it is partial agonist of 5-hydroxytryptamine receptor in uterus, placenta and umbilical blood vessels and some areas in the brain. It has weak agonistic action of 5-hydroxytryptamine but no antagonistic effect of alpha receptors. It is a potent antagonist of 5-hydroxytryptamine 2 in intestine. It has less dopaminergic action in chemoreceptor trigger zone. It is more prominent in uterine myometrium. Next, ergotamine is a amino acid alkaloid. It has partial agonist and antagonist of alpha adrenergic and 5-hydroxytryptamine 1 and 5-HT2 receptors, but no interaction with 5-HT3 or dopaminergic receptors. It shows actions like sustained vasoconstriction, visceral smooth muscle contraction and vasomotor center depression. It antagonizes action of noradrenaline and 5-hydroxytryptamine in smooth muscles. It does not show any significant effect on blood pressure. It is a potent emetic via chemoreceptor trigger zone and oxytocin, and its prolonged use causes vasoconstriction and damaged endothelium. And next, ergot derivative or dihydroergotamine. It is a hydrogenated ergotamine. It has less serotonergic action than ergotamine and less alpha adrenergic agonistic action. It is a better blocker of alpha adrenergic receptor. It has less vasoconstriction and less intimal damage. It causes less oxytocin and emetic effects. And pharmacokinetics of ergot alkaloids, it has poor bioavailability, that is only 1%, and it has incomplete absorption and first pass metabolism. It is also given by sublingual and rectal route, metabolized in liver and excreted in bile. This ergotamine is sequestrated to tissues. Plasma half-life is 2 hours. It crosses blood-brain barrier and it causes adverse effects are nausea, vomiting, muscle cramps, weakness, paresthesia, coronary and other vasospasms, and it also causes chest pain. And contraindications are, it is contraindicated in sepsis and IHD, impaired hepatic or renal function, peripheral vascular diseases, hypertension, liver diseases and pregnancy. Next, 5-hydroxytryptamine antagonist is cyproheptadine. It has a blocking property of 5-hydroxytryptamine 2A. It is also having properties like H1 antihistaminic and anticholinergic and sedative actions. It is also used for increased appetite. And coming into the uses, it is used in allergic reactions, means it effective in controlling skin allergies and pruritus, and it is also used in serotonin syndrome. It can occur when you give an increased dose of serotonin or certain serotogenic medications. It is used in serotonin syndrome, and it is also used in carcinoid syndrome. Means it is used in intestinal hypermotility and carcinoid syndrome, and it is also used in priapism. It is nothing but erectile dysfunction. For that we have to use fluoxetine also. It is injected directly into the penis, and it is also used to increase appetite in children. And cyproheptadine adverse effects are weight gain, drowsiness and dry mouth, etc. Next antagonist is ketanserin. It is a selective 5-HT2 receptor blocker, and it has no significant effect on 5-hydroxytryptamine 3 and 5-hydroxytryptamine 4 receptors. And it has high affinity for alpha adrenergic and H1. Receptor blocking and dopaminergic receptors. It induces platelet aggregation and airway constriction. It is also used as a hypertensive agent. Other drugs like clozapine, risperidone and ondansetron, etc. Next antagonist is 5-hydroxyclozapine. It is a antagonist of 5-HT2A and 2C receptors. It represents a class of atypical antipsychotic drugs with reduced in use of extrapyramidal side effects of compared to the classical neuroleptics. Other agents like risperidone, fenfluramine and olanzapine. Next 5-hydroxytryptamine antagonist is methysergide. It is a congener of methyl ergonovine. It blocks 5-hydroxytryptamine 2A and 5-hydroxytryptamine 2C receptors. It is a partial agonist activity in some preparations. It inhibits the vasoconstrictor and pressor effects under action of 5-hydroxytryptamine on various types of extravascular smooth muscle. It also interacts with 5-hydroxytryptamine 1 receptor. The therapeutic effects appear primarily to reflect blockade of 5-HT2 receptors. It is a weak vasoconstrictor and oxytocin activity. And uses it is used for the prophylactic treatment of migraine and other vascular headaches. It is without use, without benefit when given during an acute migraine attack. The protective effect takes 1 to 2 days to develop and disappears slowly when the treatment is terminated due to the accumulation of an acute metabolite of methyl sulfide, methyl ergotamine, which is more potent than the parent drug. It is also used in diarrhea malabsorption in patients with carcinoid tumors. Adverse effects are gastrointestinal disturbances, causes heartburn, diarrhea, cramps, nausea and vomitings, and symptoms related to vasospasm. It induced ischemia, numbness and tingling of the extremities, pain in the extremities and low back, and abdominal pain. It affects attributable to central actions include unsteadiness, drowsiness, weakness, lightheadedness, nervousness, insomnia, confusion, excitement and hallucinations. And this prolonged treatment leads to inflammatory fibrosis, giving rise to the various syndromes: retroperitoneal fibrosis, pleuropulmonary fibrosis and coronary and endocardial fibrosis. This fibrosis regresses after drug withdrawal. And next, 5-hydroxytryptamine antagonist is the ondansetron. It is a selective 5-HT3 antagonist with remarkable efficacy in controlling emesis with highly emetic anti-cancer drugs. Next, we will discuss about migraine. What is migraine? There are several types of migraine headaches, but most are characterized by severe pain. Severe pain on one or both sides of the head, which may move to the other side. It causes nausea, dizziness, visual disturbances, and by dilatation and constriction of the blood vessels in the head. What is migraine? It is a severe thrombic pulsating headache, usually unilateral headaches. It will stay few hours or few days. It is associated with nausea, vomiting, sensitivity to light and sound, flashes of light and loose motions and others. These are the symptoms. It is a thrombing or severe pulsating headache, usually unilateral or one side. It will stay few hours to few days. And symptoms are nausea, vomiting, and sensitivity to light and sound and loose motions. It has divided into two types: classical with aura and without aura. It is nothing but common headache. And coming into the pathophysiology, it is pulsatile dilatation of temporal or certain cranial vessels. And vascular theory is a initial vasoconstriction or shunting of blood through carotid, arterio and venous anastomosis, causing cerebral ischemia. And neurogenic theory is a depression of cortical electrical activity followed by depression. And this migraine attacks associated with, based on histological studies, sterile neurogenic perivascular edema and inflammation. And this migraine has been divided into three types: mild, that is mild, moderate, and severe migraine. In mild migraine, we have to prescribe NSAIDs, non-steroidal anti-inflammatory drugs, and anti-emetics. These are the optional. Anti-emetics is the optional drug. NSAIDs or ibuprofen, paracetamol, naproxen, mefenamic acid, and diclofenac. And anti-emetics are metoclopramide and domperidone. These drugs are used in mild migraine. And in moderate migraine is intense thrombic headache. It is lasting for 6 to 12 hours, causes nausea and vomiting, and functionally impaired patient. In this condition, we had to give NSAIDs, non-steroidal anti-inflammatory drugs, and anti-emetics like ondansetron, and specific drugs like ergots or others like sumatriptan. Means this is nothing but 5-hydroxytryptamine agonist drug. Triptans, this belong to triptans group. And in severe migraine, severe migraine is a long-lasting headache. If patient will get more than 2 to 3 attacks per month, this is lasting for 12 to 8 hours, and symptoms are vertigo and vomiting, and patient is completely incapacitated. In this condition, we have to give NSAIDs. Cannot relieve symptoms, we have to give specific anti-migraine drugs like ergotalkaloids, like ergometrine, ergotamine, and some triptans like sumatriptan. And also having some prophylactic regimens, we'll see in next slide. Ergotamine, it is ergotalkaloid and 5-hydroxytryptamine antagonist and partial agonist drug. It is the most effective ergotalkaloid, and it is a partial agonist of 5-HT1B and 1D. It constriction of dilated temporal vessels and constricts of carotid heavy shunt channels. It reduction of neurogenic inflammation and leakage of plasma in the durometer. It is given by oral and sublingual route. The dose is 6 milligrams per day. And ergotamine pharmacokinetics is, bioavailability is 1% when we'll give given by oral route. It has high first pass metabolism. It is also given by sublingual route and rectal sublingual and rectal route. It is metabolized in liver and excreted in bile, and it is sequestrated to the tissues and long lasting effect. It crosses blood brain barrier. And adverse effects are nausea, vomiting, abdominal pain, muscle cramps, and also causes chest pain, vascular spasm, and etc. And dihydroxytryptamine is also equal effective as ergotamine. It is preferred for parenteral administration. and it is also given by oral route with combination of caffeine 100 milligrams for enhancing oral absorption. This combination with caffeine and paracetamol and belladonna combinations are available in the market. Our next drug is sumatriptan. It is a selective 5-hydroxytryptamine 1B and 1D agonistic drug. It has no interaction with other 5-hydroxytryptamine receptors and with adrenergic and dopaminergic and cholinergic receptors. And it is poorly absorbed from GIT. Bioavailability is 10-15%. Complete absorption after subcutaneous administration only. It is metabolized by monoamine oxidase and excreted in urine. Plasma half-life is 2-3 hours. And mechanism of action of sumatriptan, it constriction, dilatation of extracerebral blood vessels by blockade of 5-hydroxytryptamine 1D and 1B receptors, and it constricts arteriovenous shunt of carotid artery, and it inhibits the release of 5-hydroxytryptamine and inflammation neuroleptics around the affected vessels, the suppression of neurogenic inflammation. And it is a well tolerated than ergotamine. The sumatriptan dose is 50-100 milligrams as initial dose and repeated after 24 hours if dose is required. It should not be given in first dose phase. Subcutaneous dose is 12 milligrams stat and repeated if required. Adverse effects are dose related. Causes tightness of chest, feeling of heat, paresthesia of limbs, dizziness and weakness. These adverse effects are common with subcutaneous route. Contraindications are impaired hepatic disorder or epilepsy, hypertension, pregnancy or hepatic and renal impairment. Other triptans are rizatriptan, zolmitriptan, naratriptan and amlotriptan. And prophylaxis of migraine necessary when attacks are frequent, 2 or more attacks per month. The aim is to abolish attacks totally. Discontinue every 4-6 months and observe. For that, beta adrenergic blockers such as propranolol and timolol and tricyclic antidepressants such as amitriptyline and calcium channel blockers verapamil, it is not used now because it is a weak calcium channel blocker, and it is also used for prophylaxis of migraine is anticonvulsants such as valproic acid and gabapentin and topiramate. These are the drugs used for migraine prophylaxis. Thank you.